Sexy music from Hungary, a piece I first heard on a violin called Csáros. I used to play it with just one rhythm, something like this. But last year I was in the south of France at a theatre festival at a place called Avignon. I was performing this piece on the street when a group of incredibly drunk theatre festival attendees decided to get up and dance and clap and sing completely out of time. So I thought, if they're going to dance and clap and sing out of time, then I'm going to play out of time. So I tried to follow them, they tried to follow me. We danced, clapped, sang, played completely out of time for the whole piece. And it was a lot of fun. So I still play like this, but now it's kind of like a drunken Hungarian. No worries, drunken Hungarian dance. But at the end of the piece, I also added an Italian melody with the same rhythm. Speak no Americano. This is some Tigan music, some gypsy music from Hungary, a piece all the way from Italy, my version, from the violin, onto the guitar. The drunken version. My microphone's sort of playing up a bit. Thank you very much. Thank you. That's some gypsy music from Hungary in a dance. A piece, We Don't Speak No Americano, from Italy. Which brings me to the last piece I'm going to play just for you guys today. And this is some music from Russia. It's a piece written by Modest Mussorgsky. Does anybody here know Mussorgsky? But just before I play it, just to help this guy out, can you guys come in a little bit? Because he's asking you to move in so that the police car can park. Just in. So this is the last piece I'm going to play. It starts to get very busy here when they close the road. And so this is my last piece. So does anybody know Mussorgsky? Mussorgsky? One? Yeah, one, two, three. About five or six people? Does anybody here know Justin Bieber? No? No one. Oh, one person. That's a good one. More people know Mussorgsky than Justin Bieber. You might not have heard of Mussorgsky, but you may recognize. You might recognize this melody. Theme to a piece he wrote called Pictures at an Exhibition. It's originally written for the piano in about 1840. And you can hear this in a few different ways. It's most famous for an orchestration by a French composer, Ravel. And when you hear people perform it, it often sounds like this. Differently, a little bit sadder, because the exhibition, that's Mussorgsky, music he wrote to depict himself as he walks into an exhibition and uses that theme as he walks between 10 paintings. I played a little bit slower, a little bit sadder, because it was not just any exhibition, it was an exhibition for his close friend Victor Hartmann when he died, so it was a memorial exhibition. And so I played a little bit different. But I'm only going to play the last movement, because the whole piece is about 40 minutes long and 15 movements. So I'm just going to play the last movement, which is called The Great Gate of Kiev. It's a piece which is special to me. And it's about a design of Victor Hartmann, Mussorgsky's close friend, a design for a great gate to be an entrance to Kiev. And on the top of the gate, there's a bell tower. So throughout the piece, especially towards the end, you hear the sounds of bells, sometimes in the nighttime. As they chime down. And with the melody. Underneath the bell tower, there's an archway. And Mussorgsky uses Victor Hartmann's archway, and he writes the sound of a procession using a Russian Orthodox hymn going through the archway, a memorial procession for Victor Hartmann. Twice, and surrounding the hymns and the bells is just a beautiful melody he wrote for his friend. So this is the last movement from Pictures of an Exhibition, The Great Gate of Kiev, my arrangement from the piano onto the guitar, written by Modest Mussorgsky in memoriam for Victor Hartmann. Just one moment. I'm not sure who belongs to this, but it's probably not good to sit right in front of the speaker because it's going to be a bit too loud. Thank you. Great Gate of Kiev, some music from Muzorgsky. If you love the music, feel free to come and say hello, come and shake my hand, have a look at the guitar, have a chat, and also, of course, I have a...